Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan. I am going to discuss the subject gas dynamics and jet propulsion through the video lectures. And this is lecture number GDJP01. The topic is Introduction to Gas Dynamics. In the earlier lecture, we reviewed the fluid mechanics and thermodynamics. We discussed the fluid properties and various types of fluid flow. Also, we discussed the thermodynamics, the various thermodynamics properties of the fluid, and the various laws like zeroth law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics, second law of thermodynamics, and the thermodynamic properties like temperature, internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, etc. The basics on fluid mechanics and thermodynamics are the prerequisite for the subject. So we will be using those basic properties frequently in the subject gas dynamics and jet propulsion. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the Mach number and types of fluid flow based on the Mach number, Mach waves, and the governing equation, which is the basic for the gas dynamics, the subject gas dynamics. And at the end of the lecture, you will be able to define what is Mach number and classify the flow based on the Mach number and summarize the governing equations for gas dynamics. And the Mach number and the Mach waves. So Mach number is named after the German physicist and the philosopher Ernst Mach. The Mach number is defined as the ratio of local fluid velocity to the local sonic velocity, or velocity of the sound at the same point. So the m equal to c by a, where c is the velocity of the fluid and a is the velocity of the sound. So this definition is very much important. The entire subject is based on the Mach number. You have to remember m equal to c by a. There is another way to define or interpret the Mach number, m equal to square root of inertia force by the elastic force, which is square root of rho a c square, which is inertia force, and elastic force is k s into a. So inertia force rho a c square, rho is the density of the fluid, a is the area, and c is the velocity of the fluid. And here the k s is the bulk, isentropic bulk modulus of elasticity, equals to rho a square, and substituting for ks, simplifying, once again Mach number equal to c by a. And based on the Mach number, we classify the flow as incompressible flow, subsonic flow, supersonic flow, and hypersonic flow. So when the Mach number is very much lower than the 1, the flow is referred as incompressible flow, like the flow of liquid, flow of any liquid like water and the oil. And when Mach number is less than 1, the flow is known as subsonic flow. Mach number is greater than 1, the flow is called as supersonic flow. And hypersonic flow, where the Mach number is very much greater than 1. And when the Mach number is equal to 1, the flow is referred as sonic flow. And there is a region where the Mach number is fluctuating between subsonic condition and supersonic condition, and that is called as transonic flow. So transonic flow, where the Mach number is slightly less than 1 and slightly greater than 1. Hypersonic flow, when the Mach number is greater than 5, the flow is referred as hypersonic flow. And we will discuss the Mach waves. First, for the incompressible flow, where the Mach number is less than, very much less than 1. And the incompressible flow, the Mach number is c by a. C is the velocity of the fluid and A is the velocity of the sound in the fluid. And referring to the diagram, I have S is the source point, and the circles are the sound waves propagating at a different time. So t equal to 1, t equal to 2, and t equal to 3. And the sound, as the source point is creating the sound wave, the source point is moving with velocity u, and the sound waves are propagating with the velocity a. So the Mach number equal to u by a, the velocity of the object divided by the velocity of the sound wave. So t equal to 1, when time t equal to 0 or t equal to 1, this is the first sound wave created, which is moving with the velocity a. T equal to the second sound wave created, which is moving with the velocity 2a, and third sound wave is moving with the velocity 3a. So what do you mean by that? 3a is the sound wave created 3 seconds earlier, 2a is the sound wave created 2 seconds earlier, and a is the sound wave created 1 second earlier. So the sound waves are moving towards the outside. So from the center, it is moving outside. And how to get the sound wave for the incompressible flow or wave for the incompressible flow? You take a bucket of water, a full bucket of water, and you put a small stone at the center. Slowly put a small stone at the center of the bucket, and you find that the waves are created, and the waves are moving towards the bucket outer wall and disappears. That is what the waves in the incompressible flow. And with reference to the incompressible flow, now we discuss, define what is the subsonic flow, a Mach wave for the subsonic flow. And here the source point is moving with velocity, and these are the sound waves are created at different time. T equal to 3 means the sound wave created 3 minutes earlier, 3 seconds earlier, T equal to 2 seconds earlier, and T equal to 1 second earlier. And the sound wave, the source point is moving very slowly, and the sound waves are moving at a faster speed. So the sound waves are ahead of the source point. So this is called as subsonic flow. For the subsonic flow, the sound waves are moving at a higher speed comparing with the source point. And the sonic flow, Mach number equal to 1. Mach number equal to 1 means C equal to A. So C is the velocity of the source point, or U is the velocity of the source point, and A is the velocity of the sound wave. Both are moving with the same speed. You may find the sound waves are propagating in this fashion. So we take the supersonic flow, where M equal to 2. I take M equal to 2, where the source point is moving with a speed, double the speed of the sound wave. You may find the sound waves are propagating slowly than the source point. Now we can draw a tangent to the sound waves from the source point, and the area within the tangents are called as Mach cone. So inside the Mach cone, the zone is called as zone of action, where you find the sound waves. Outside the cone, there is no disturbance. That is called a zone of silence. And you can calculate the Mach angle alpha in terms of Mach number. That is what the supersonic flow, where you find the sound waves are behind the source point. So we have discussed the sound wave for the subsonic flow, sonic flow, and the supersonic flow. To understand the concept in a better way, I give a clipping from the YouTube. You may find the flight is moving slowly with the sound waves at the blue. These are the blue color lines are the sound waves. Now this is for the subsonic flow, where the sound waves are moving with a faster speed than the flight. So for subsonic flow, Mach number is less than 1. This is called as subsonic flight. So where the sound waves are ahead of the flight. And for the sonic condition, this is the sound wave, where the flight is moving with the speed C equal to A. So the sound waves and the flights are moving with the same speed. This is for the sonic flight. And for the supersonic flight, the sound waves are behind. The flight is moving ahead of the sound waves. So this is called as supersonic flow. Now you take a reflection spot. So from the earlier discussion, you try to define what is Mach number. You take few seconds and define what is Mach number. So if you are written this answer, Mach number is the ratio of velocity of the fluid to the velocity of the sound, m equal to c by a, you are correct. And here you match the following. In the left hand side I have m equal to 1, m is much greater than 1, m is greater than 1, m is less than 1, m is much less than 1. On the other side, incompressible flow, sonic flow, subsonic flow, hypersonic flow and the supersonic flow. You try to match left side and the right side. And if your answer m equal to 1, there is sonic flow. M is much greater than 1 is hypersonic flow. M is greater than 1 is supersonic flow. M is less than 1 is subsonic flow. And M is much less than 1, which is incompressible flow. So if you have answers like this, and you are a good student, we congratulate. And next we discuss on the continuity governing equation for gas dynamics. So the four governing equations for the gas dynamics are continuity equation, momentum equation, energy equation and equation of state. We will discuss one by one. A continuity equation, it is from the mass conservation principle. So the continuity equation for steady one dimensional flow is derived from the conservation of mass. So you consider a passage of varying cross section. Section 1 is the inlet and section 2 is the outlet. At the entry point, the density is the rho is the density of the fluid, c is the velocity of the fluid, and a1 is the area of the cross section. And at the exit side, rho 2 is the velocity of the density of the fluid, and c2 is the velocity of the fluid, and a2 is the area of the cross section. From the continuity equation, mass of the fluid entering on the left side and equal to mass of the fluid leaving on the right side. So that is what the continuity equation m1 equal to m2. Where rho m1 equal to rho 1 a1 c1, rho is the density, a is the area and c is the velocity, which is equal to rho 2 a2 c2. This is what the continuity equation, and this equation is important for all our discussion or problems in future. So you remember the continuity equation. So in general, we call the continuity equation rho ac equal to constant. Rho is the density, a is the cross-sectional area and c is the velocity of the fluid. And differentiating this equation in differential form, the continuity equation is dc by c plus dA by a plus d rho by rho equal to 0. And the three equations are important for our further discussion. And momentum equation is based on the momentum principle or Newton's second law of motion, which states that at any instant, the rate of change of momentum of fluid is equal to the resultant force acting on it. So F equal to ma, that is what the equation we are familiar, which is mass into acceleration is rate of change of momentum, F is the net force. So we consider the passage with the section 1 inlet, section 2 outlet, and within the inlet and the outlet, we take a small fluid element of width dx. On the left side of the fluid element, the pressure is P and the area is A. On the right side, the pressure is increased to P plus dP and the area is increased to A plus dA. And we assume the fluid element is moving from left to right. And for this fluid element, dF is the frictional force acting on the wall. Now, for calculating Newton's second law of motion, this is net force in x direction is equal to rate at which momentum leaves the x direction at point 2 minus rate at which momentum enter the x direction at point 1. So here we can take this element, and this is the exit section, this is the outlet section. So momentum at the outlet minus momentum at the inlet. And neglecting the various forces, we consider only the pressure force and the frictional force. We neglect the gravitational force, viscous force, everything. We consider only the pressure force and the frictional force exerted on the surface of the control volume. So the pressure force, net pressure force equal to P plus A minus PA into PA plus P plus DP into A plus DP DA plus 1 by 2 into P plus P plus DP into A plus DA minus A. This is what the change in pressure force minus df is the frictional force which is acting in the opposite direction. And simplifying this equation, neglecting the higher order terms, minus A into dP minus dF is the net force acting on the control volume. And rate of change of momentum is mass into change in the velocity. So rho AC into change in velocity is DC. So the rho AC into DC, that is what the rate of change of momentum. So now the net force acting on the element is equal to rate of change of momentum. So substituting, you will get minus A dP minus dF, that is equal to rho A into dc. That is what the net force, and this is the rate of change of momentum. Now, neglecting the frictional forces, we will get A dP equal to rho A dc. On simplification, we will get dP by rho minus dP by rho equal to c into dc. And this is known as Euler's equation. This is the momentum equation in the form of Euler's equation for steady flow in a duct. What is the significance of this equation? This equation indicates that decrease in velocity is always associated with the increase in pressure as vice versa. So that means in a momentum equation says, when the velocity decreases, pressure will increase. When the pressure decreases, velocity will increase. And integrating the Euler's equation, you will get the equation like this. When rho is constant, right, when the rho is constant, and this equation becomes c square by 2 plus p by rho equal to constant. And when rho is constant, the flow is called as incompressible flow. So this is the Euler's equation for incompressible flow. And this equation is referred as Bernoulli's equation. So this equation already we derived in the fluid mechanics. So the Bernoulli's equation applicable only for the incompressible fluid flow, that is we have to remember. So this is the Euler's equation and this is the Bernoulli's equation applicable for incompressible fluid flow. And the energy equation is derived from the energy conservation principle, that energy conservation law, which states that energy neither be created nor destroyed and can be transformed from one form to another form. So this energy equation we are going to derive from the steady flow energy equation what we discuss in the thermodynamics. So this is what the steady flow energy equation, g z1 plus c1 square by 2 plus h1 plus w equal to g z2 plus c2 square by 2 plus h3 plus q, where w is the work done and q is the heat transfer. Z1, c1, h1 at the inlet, z2, c2, h2 at the outlet. Now for the flow, the duct is horizontal, so Z1 equal to Z2, that is getting cancelled, and the fluid is just flowing through the duct, there is no work done, so W equal to 0, and the duct is insulated, so there is no heat transfer, Q equal to 0. So there is no heat transfer, Q equal to 0, there is no work done, W equal to 0, duct is horizontal, Z1 equal to Z2. Finally, we have C1 square by 2 plus H1 equal to C2 square by 2 plus H2, that is the energy equation, steady flow energy equation. For the gas dynamics calculation. And for ideal gas, H equal to Cp into T, then Cp into T1 plus C1 square by 2 equal to Cp into T2 plus C2 square by 2. And we may write differentiate in differential form. This equation is written as Cp into dT plus Cdc equal to 0. And this is called as energy equation differential form. And this equation indicates the temperature, when the temperature increases, velocity will decrease, and when the temperature decreases, velocity will increase. That is what the effect of the equation. And the equation of state from the perfect gas equation given by P by rho T equal to constant, and writing this equation between two conditions, inlet and the outlet, P1 by rho 1 T, that is equal to P2 by rho 2 T. Or we can write this equation for a small change in the volume as P by rho T equal to P plus dP divided by rho plus d rho multiplied by T plus dT. So there is P plus dP is a small increase in the pressure due to the for the small incremental small volume, and rho plus d rho is the change in the density, T plus dT is the change in the temperature. And we rearrange the equation as like this. So P by rho T is getting cancelled. So one finally we will get 1 equal to P plus 1 plus dP by P multiplied by 1 plus d rho by rho to the power minus 1 into 1 plus dt by t to the power minus 1. And to ignore or delete the minus 1, this equation is modified like this: 1 equal to 1 plus dp by p plus 1 minus d rho by rho multiplied by 1 minus dt by t. So expanding the right hand side and simplifying, we will get dp by p minus d rho by rho minus dt by t equal to 0. We have to delete the higher order term. And this is the differential form of the equation of state, which is giving the relationship between change in pressure, change in density, and change in temperature. And we have a reflections part here. Based on the discussion what we heard earlier, we just try to match the following. So the left hand side, we have continuity equation, momentum equation, energy equation, equation of state. And the right hand side, we have the energy conservation principle, perfect gas equation, mass conservation principle, and Newton's second law of motion. You take few seconds and you try to match left side and the right side. And for continuity equation is mass conservation principle, based on the mass conservation principle. Momentum equation is based on the Newton's second law of motion. Energy equation is based on the energy conservation principle. And equation of state is based on the perfect gas equation. If your answer is this, I congratulate you for your better learning. So the lecture is based on my book, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. In this book, the subject matter is explained in a lucid manner, so for the beginner to understand. And we have more number of solved problem from anonymous question paper, and two more question and answer also given at the end of each chapter. And if you have the book for your further clarification and the discussion, and the book is published by the Anuradha Publication, Chennai. For any clarification or queries, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will answer within 24 hours. So thank you. We'll meet again.